This is third lecture on media and margins, and he has already delivered two lectures, one on the basic concepts of marginality and the other on marginality in India. And today, that is in his third lecture, he'll be talking about media representation of the marginalized. I would request sir also to use a little bit of Odia if it's possible during his talk for the convenience of our learners. And the rules are similar. The questions can be written in the dashboard. Dashboard re kindly questions would likhi pe. A questions would at the end of the lecture they will be addressed. So let us not interrupt the speaker. Let us not interrupt the resource person in between the lecture. So it's over to you, Professor Das.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Before I begin, I will start with a kind of a quiz I would like to share, but not necessarily that students should respond to the quiz, but I would like to explain that. आमे माने आजिकाली जो कैमरा मोबाइल हलानी बहुत समय रे आमे सब आमे आमा फोटो उठाउचे वी टेक स्नैप्स वी टेक पिक्चर्स ऑफ आवर्स नाउ व्हेन आई सी दोज फोटोग्राफ्स द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस व्हाट डू आई सी What do I see? What do I see? When I see the photographs, what do I see?
Lens.
My question is it me? Is it me? That is my question. Yes? Is it me?
No, sir. Only lens.
Only?
Lens, sir.
Lens money?
As when we are taking the photograph, we are only focuses on the lens of the camera. The objects, the comes automatically, sir.
No. You didn't understand what I'm saying. Because you are using an automatic camera, right?
Yes, sir.
So, because of the mobile, the automatic. I'm not talking about the lens, what it adjusts. The output which you see. আপনার যে ছবি দেখিলে মাই কোয়েশ্চেন ইজ ইট মি দ্যাট ইজ মাই কোয়েশ্চেন
Yes, sir.
দ্যাট ইজ হোয়াট আই ওয়ান্ট টু রিজেক্ট
Okay,
ইট ইজ নট মি
sir. Maybe it is a representation of yourself. It is a representation of yourself.
নাও দেন দ্য কোয়েশ্চেন অ্যারাইজেস হোয়াট ইজ রেপ্রেজেন্টেশন
Maybe what?
ইজ রেপ্রেজেন্টেশন করেক্ট Is representation done in a right way? Or there are problems with the camera itself? It's before you go to representation. Let me clarify that what I see, jota mu dekhe, jo picture tak mu dekhe, that in media studies or in semiotics, jo meanings ame thole bujuche, ame kohu je ki it looks like me, but it is not me. You understand the difference? It looks like me, but it is not me. The reason is camera photographs is a two-dimensional space. It tries to fix you, museumize you, makes you like an object so that you can hang it in the wall, like a photograph, a frame. So it's a two-dimensional space. তা ভিতরে গোটে স্টাটিক ক্যাটেগরিরে করে দিয়েছি হিউম্যান বিইংস উই আর অল থ্রি ডাইমেনশনাল উই আর লিভিং বিইংস দেন দ্য কোয়েশ্চেন অ্যারাইজেস নো ম্যাটার ইট লুকস লাইক মি বাট ইট ট্রাইজ টু ক্যাপচার মাই মুড ইন আ পার্টিকুলার স্পেস অ্যান্ড টাইম ওকে সেই সময়ে মু সেমিতিয়া লাগুছিলি তা মানে নুহে কি যে থ্রু আউট দ্য ডে আই উইল বিহেভ লাইক দ্যাট ইউ আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড হোয়াট আই অ্যাম সেইং এটা হচ্ছে কাম এটা হচ্ছে রোনা বার্থস র কাম ইন মাইথোলজিস ইফ ইউ সি ইন ক্যামেরা লুসিডা রোনা বার্থস রাইটস অ্যাবাউট দ্যাট হোয়াট অ্যাকচুয়ালি ইজ ক্যামেরা ইজ অল অ্যাবাউট ইট লুকস লাইক মি বাট ইট ইজ নট মি দ্যাট আইডিয়া অফ সিমিলি লুকস লাইক ওয়েন আই সে লুকস লাইক মি ইফ ইউ লুক ব্যাক টু দ্য হিস্ট্রি অফ ফটোগ্রাফিক জার্নালিজম ইউ ফাইন্ড দ্যাট ক্যামেরা was never taken seriously. Camera or photographs were never taken seriously because it was the language which had the power, which had the power. the way I speak, the way I articulate, the way I write, that had the power, the little written language. But visuals or camera was never taken seriously. कि आज फोटोग्राफ्स गुड़ा को भाया यूज होता जुडिशियल वेरिफिकेशन पुलिस विटनेसेस यही सब कंटेक्स्ट रे फोटोग्राफ्स गुड़ा यूज होता फोटोग्राफ गोटे सीरियस टूल ऑफ रिसर्च और फोटोग्राफिक एज ए मेथड एज ए टूल कुड नेवर इमर्ज कैन नेवर इमर्ज और इवन कैन नॉट डेवलप एज एन अल्टरनेटिव कॉन्टेक्स्ट टू रिसर्च आज मुझे कहबी कि जो जदि आप रिसर्च कर आई एम बीइंग आस्किंग यू दैट ओके यू राइट योर थीसिस इनस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग लेट्स से 50,000 वर्ड्स इफ आई से दैट जस्ट गिव मी ए फोटोग्राफिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ योर थीसिस एंड आस्क दैट कैन फोटोग्राफी बी यूज एज अ टूल ऑफ रिसर्च बुझे कि एनीवे सो आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू क्लारीफाई दैट आजिकल आप देखिए विजुअल एंथ्रोपोलॉजी आसला विजुअल सोशियोलॉजी आसलानी ये सब नुआ नुआ इे सब विजुअल ये मेथड टाक यूज कराऊँ एज अ टूल फॉर रिसर्च इट इज नॉट एन एडिशन टू द एक्जिस्टिंग रिसर्च बट इटसेल्फ बिकम्स ए मेजर टूल ऑफ रिसर्च माने आ नुह कि जो आजिकल जो थीसिस गुड़ा फोटो दे दूचे आम कहे कि सब फोटो गुड़ा लाइक ए वेरिफिकेशन इट्स नॉट आई वुड लाइक टू प्रेजेंट माय एसे थ्रू फोटोग्राफिक फॉर्म लेट द फोटो स्पीक Let the visual speak. Idea of representation became much more stronger because society is becoming more and more mediated. I'm a direct face-to-face of contact kori parune. Sei context re kemiti media asila. Even it's not only media. If you look at the idea, the notion of representation, it has a severe connotation. When a connotative ala with a subjective meaning when we say. So that is how it has used. It has been used. Now, theory of representation. I mean, today our topic is representation of the marginals. Representation माने कौन? Representation माने कौन? ये जो तीन इटा lecture, ये जो प्रथम lecture मु margin marginality, ये डा conceptual issue ऊपर दली. Second टा मु दली जे larger notion of marginalization. What are the social contexts? What are the socio-economic context? जो context रे marginalization होची, process टा होची. Third, आजी जो मु कहिया को जाऊची, मु कहूची जे representation. Representation माने मने रखूँ तू, जे we are actually studying the meaning systems. We are trying to study the meaning systems encoded in the text. सही जो text मु कहूची, text माने कौन? Text होची, it can be a photographic text. It can be a cinematic text, it can be a televisual text, or even a kind of a literary essays, what you see. They're all considered as a text. Jodi text hala, jodi ame gote text kohiba, media studies re ame jetole bujhiyaku chesta koruche, tinita jinsa apan bujhiyaku chesta karuntu. Ame jetole audience ku study koruche, ame broadly tinita category re I will try to put them all together. One is, मीडिया यूज आप मन रखु गोटे हूँ मीडिया यूज द्वितीय मीडिया सेकेंड है यूजर थर्ड टा है यूसेज यूज यूजर एंड यूसेज दीज आर द थ्री डिस्टिंक्ट कैटेगरीज नाउ व्हेन आई एम सेइंग मीडिया यूज जिते आप ट्रेडिशनल स्टडीज मीडिया रे देखिए कम्युनिकेशन रे देखिए यू विल इनवेरिएबली फाइंड दैट वी आर ट्राइंग टू identify we are trying to find out to what extent people using media mane apan ko jo effect study jo kahanti jo conventional effect studies apan dekhuchanti seguda actually media is a, it's a kind of a determinism it's a technology centered ame kete media through re influence hoche media kete am upare impact karuchi jo impact studies hochi effect studies hochi sethre gote media ko gote ऑडियंस को गोटे पैसिव कैटेगरी देखा जमी गोटे काउच पटाटो ऑडियंस गोटे बसीचि मीडिया मेसेज आसो धोई नहीं जीव माने गोटे इनफ्लुएंस कर नहीं जीव सो दैट इज वन स्कूल ऑफ थॉट सो कन्वेंशनल जी कम्युनिकेशन मीडिया रिसर्च होती आप देखिए इनवेरिएबली दैट इज अ डिटरमिनिज्म टेक्नोलॉजिकल डिटरमिनिज्म अंत कहु जोटा कि मीडिया इन्फ्लुएंस करिचे इंडिविजुअल्स ऊपर वी आर नॉट सटिस्फाइड विद दैट वी आर नॉट सटिस्फाइड विद दैट काइंड ऑफ रिसर्च सो व्हाट वी सॉर्ट ऑफ ट्राई टू डू इज वी ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड नो 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 इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी दैट वी आर अ पैसिव सब्जेक्ट वी आर लाइक ए काउच पोटैटो दैट वी विल बी अब्सॉर्ब्ड बाय द मीडिया इटसेल्फ इवन वी आर सब्जेक्टेड एंड वी आर सॉर्ट ऑफ ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग सिस्टम्स तो सेठी आसला यूजर मीडिया यूजर जोटा कि गोटे सब्जेक्टिविटी आसला ऑडियंस आ पैसिव नहीं ऑडियंस बर्तन सब्जेक्टिव ऑडियंस बर्तन मीनिंग खोजुची चारिआडे वेदर इट इज टेलीविजन हला सिनेमा रे हला रेडियो रे बट दैट मीनिंग लुकिंग फॉर अ मीनिंग आइडेंटिफाइंग अ मीनिंग लुक बट दैट मीनिंग ऑल्सो मे वेरी अक्रॉस पीपुल अक्रॉस कल्चर अक्रॉस सोसाइटी अक्रॉस इवन क्लासेस राइट माने आपण देखिबे गोटे स्लम रे जाई के आपण स्टडी करिवे टेलीविजन रो कोन इंपैक्ट आउ गोटे अपर मिडिल क्लास हाउस होल्ड रे लोकंकु पचारिवे आपण डेफिनेटली विल फाइंड अ डिफरेंट अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट द सेम मेसेज सो दैट इज व्हाट यू फाइंड दैट कल्चर सब कल्चर डिफरेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट रे तार मेसेज रो कोन इंपैक्ट पडुची जेतल टेक्स्ट आमे जेतल कहूचे जो रिप्रेजेंटेशन बिषय आमे कहूचे आमे जो कहे कि रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मार्जिनल्स रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मार्जिनल्स आमे एक्चुअली मेसेज को देखुचे जो जो टेक्स्ट आपण कहउचंती दैट इज एक्चुअली एट द मेसेज लेवल से टेक्स्ट जे प्रोड्यूस करुची द प्रोड्यूस करुची आउ एज एन ऑडियंस वी आर रिसीवर से जो टेक्स्ट को जे प्रोड्यूस करुची से कंट्रोल करुची से मीडिया को से कंट्रोल करुची से मीडिया को से तार कौन पर्पज अच्छी से पर्टिकुलर मेसेज दबार से मेसेज टाक से टेक्स्ट करी से मीडियम रे दबार डिपेंड करुचे आमे ताको डिसाइफर करुचे मीनिंग सिस्टम कौन एथु बाहरुची सेटा को आमे बुझिया को चेष्टा करुचे गोटे एटा एक्चुअली कल्चरल स्टडीज कहंतु मीडिया स्टडीज कहंतु देयर वाज अ वेरी वेरी इंपोर्टेंट वेरी एमिनेंट स्कॉलर कॉल्ड स्टुअर्ट हॉल Stuart Hall, upon I'm sure that if you find time, upon Google, le click kari ki Stuart Hall ko click kari ve, tara theory of representation achi, sahi representation upare se gudaye kama kori chi, jo ta ki Birmingham, jo Center for Contemporary Cultural Studies, Birmingham, he was one of the founder, he is one of the leading scholar in the field of media studies, jie ki ei jo whole idea of representation upare se kama kori chi. तेणु मुझे आपको रिप्रेजेंटेशन विषय कह रिप्रेजेंटेशन को दुईटा अलग अलग टाइप बुझार अच्छी गोटे जो कन्वेंशनल अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटेशन सेकंड टा होची व्हाट इज अ न्यू वे ऑफ एंगेजिंग विद द आईडिया ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटेशन से क्लारीफाई करी वन से क्लारीफाई हालापर यू कैन एक्सटेंडेड टू अंडरस्टैंड डिफरेंट आस्पेक्ट दैट हाउ मीडिया कवर्स द मार्जिनल्स वेदर इट इज अ दलित इट इज अ tribe it is a gender it is a reason a religion anything then we would like to extend it these are substantive but first we need to have a good conceptual grasping on the idea of representation ko Stuart Hall jetole representation theory bisare kouchi se kouchi je there is no true representation of people or events in a text So, there is no true representation of people or events in a text, but there are lots of ways this can be represented. So, there are no true meaning, but there are different ways that people can be represented. So, producers try to fix a meaning or a way of understanding people or events in their text. Apana bhavantu, 18th century aguru, ଆମର ଯେଉଁ ନୋସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ରେପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ ଥିଲା ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ବିଷୟରେ କହୁଛେ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ବିଷୟରେ କହୁଛେ କି ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ଗୋଟେ ରେପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟ କରୁଛି ଆଜି ଆପଣ ଦେଖୁଛନ୍ତି ଟେଲିଭିଜନ ଆପଣ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ୟୁଜ୍ ଟର୍ମଟାକୁ ୟୁଜ୍ କରୁଛନ୍ତି ଆପଣ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ଯେ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ଆରେ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ଅଛି ମୁଁ ଆପଣଙ୍କୁ ପଚାରିବି ଯେ ସେ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ କିଏ ହୁ ଇଜ୍ ଦିସ୍ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ହୁ କନ୍ଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁଟ୍ସ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଡୁ ୟୁ ମିନ୍ ବାଇ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ୟୁ ଡିଷ୍ଟିଙ୍ଗୁଇଶ୍ ବିଟ୍ୱିନ୍ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ଅଡିଏନ୍ସ ଗ୍ରୁପ୍ You see, these are different concepts. Now, public kya? I mean, Hindi film mein bhi public kya public hai, sab janta hai. पब्लिक को यूज करा कि पब्लिक के मु आपन को पब्लिक नॉन पब्लिक पब्लिकनेस ता विषय आई कैन आल्सो स्पीक अबाउट बट हु इज पब्लिक व्हाट कॉन्स्टिट्यूट्स पब्लिक आपन आज एत चैनल्स हो गलानी ता माने कोन आपन कहबे कि बहुत पब्लिक अछंती पब्लिक माने कोन आपन ताको पब्लिक कहबे ना कंज्यूमर कहबे आजकल गोटे नुआ टर्म मीडिया स्टडीज रे यूज होची ताको कोचंती प्रोज्यूमर प्रोज्यूमर सो कोचंती इट्स नो मोर वी आर कंज्यूमिंग वी आर आल्सो प्रोड्यूसिंग बुझले कि जंदी मोबाइल रे आपन खटखट 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 बसी के 24 घंटा आपन मोबाइल रे मेसेज दउचंती से मेसेज जो जो दउचंती से जो मेसेज जो दउचंती आपन एटा जानि के रखंतु आपन एटा के गोटे पचार छी आई विल गेट बैक टू दैट सोशल स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन I will answer anyway. Sada sabu bade border rochi. I'll respond to those questions later. So itra apno jo message do chanti. What do you think? What are you doing by giving that message? How do you see that? Apno jo 24 ghanta WhatsApp re message pathau chanti. Apno jani chanti tar implication kono. Tar implication kono apno jani chanti. ସେଇ ଯେଉଁ ସବୁ ଇନଫର୍ମେସନ୍ସ ଗୁଡ଼ା ଯେଉଁ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ସଆପ୍ରେ ଦେଉଛନ୍ତି ସେ କେଉଁଠିକି ଯାଉଛି ଆପଣ ଜାଣିଛନ୍ତି ଇଟ୍ସ ଅ ପାର୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ବିଗ୍ ଡେଟା ଇଟ୍ସ ଅ ପାର୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ବିଗ୍ ଡେଟା ଇଟ୍ ହେଲ୍ପସ୍ ଫର୍ ଅଡିଏନ୍ସ ପ୍ରୋଫାଇଲିଂ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ଡୁଇଂ ଇଜ୍ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ଡୁଇଂ ଏ ଭଲେଣ୍ଟରି ଲେବର୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ଡୁଇଂ ଏ ଭଲେଣ୍ଟରି ଲେବର୍ ମାନେ ଆଗରୁ ଯେଉଁ ଲେବର୍ ପାଇଁ ପେଡ୍ ହେଉଥିଲା ଆଉ ସେ ପେଡ୍ ହେଉନାହିଁ ଆପଣ 24 ଘଣ୍ଟା ନିଜକୁ ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ମିଡ଼ିଆରେ ଫ୍ରି କରିଦେଇଛନ୍ତି ଆପଣ ଲେଖିଦେଇଛନ୍ତି ଯେ ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ଏଭେଲେବୁଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଆଇ ଏମ୍ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିବ୍ୟୁଟିଂ ଟୁ ଦ ଲେବର୍ ଆଇ ଏମ୍ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିବ୍ୟୁଟିଂ ଟୁ ଦ ଲେବର୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ୱାଇ ୟୁ ଫାଇଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ୱି ଆର୍ ଡୁଇଂ ଭଲେଣ୍ଟରିଜମ୍ ଇଟ୍ସ କଲ୍ଡ ଭଲେଣ୍ଟରି ଲେବର୍ ଏନିୱେ ମୁଁ ଆପଣଙ୍କୁ ୟୁଜ୍ ୟୁଜର୍ ରିସର୍ଚ୍ଚ ତିନିଟା କାଟେଗୋରିଜ୍ରୁ ମୁଁ ଆପଣଙ୍କୁ ଡିସ୍କସ୍ କରୁଥିଲି ଯେଉଁ ୟୁଜର୍ଟା ଆସିଲା ସେଇଟା ହେଉଛି ପାସିଭ୍ ନୁହେଁ ସେଇଟା ହେଉଛି ଅଡିଏନ୍ସ ଆଜ୍ ଏନ୍ ଆକ୍ଟିଭ୍ ସବଜେକ୍ଟ ସିଏ କ'ଣ କରୁଛି ସେ ମିନିଂସ୍ ଗୁଡ଼ାକ ଡିରାଇଭ୍ କରୁଛି ଯେଉଁ ମେସେଜେସ୍ ଗୁଡ଼ା ଆସୁଛି ଟେଲିଭିଜନ ହେଲା ରେଡ଼ିଓ ହେଲା ମୋବାଇଲ ହେଲା ସୋସିଆଲ ମିଡ଼ିଆ ହେଲା ସେ କଣ୍ଟେକ୍ସ ଯେଉଁ ମେସେଜ୍ ଆସୁଛି ସିଏ ତାକୁ ସବୁ ବୁଝିବାକୁ ଚେଷ୍ଟା କରୁଛି ସିଏ ସେଇଥିରୁ ଗୋଟେ ମିନିଂସ୍ ଡିରାଇଭ୍ କରୁଛି ନଟ୍ ନେସେସାରିଲି ଯିଏ ମେସେଜ୍କୁ ବନେଇଛି ଯିଏ ମେସେଜ୍କୁ ଯିଏ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସର୍ ଯିଏ ମେସେଜ୍କୁ ଏନକୋଡ୍ କରିଛି ଆମେ ସେଟାକୁ କହୁଛେ ଡିକୋଡିଂ ସୋ ତେଣୁ ଏନକୋଡିଂ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡିକୋଡିଂ ସ୍ଲଟ୍ ହୋଲ୍ର ଟର୍ମ ହେଉଛି ଏନକୋଡିଂ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡିକୋଡିଂ ସେ କହୁଛି ଯେ କି ଯିଏ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସର ଯିଏ ମେସେଜ୍ ବନଉଛି ସିଏ ତାର ଗୋଟେ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ପର୍ପଜ୍ ଅଛି ସିଏ କ'ଣ ପାଇଁ ମେସେଜ୍ ବନଉଛି ତାକୁ ଆମେ ଡିକୋଡ୍ କରୁଛେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ତାକୁ ଟେଲିଭିଜନରେ ଦେଖୁଛେ ମିନିଂସ୍ ଆମେ ଦେଉଛେ ସେ ମିନିଂସ୍ ନଟ୍ ନେସେସରିଲି ୱିଲ୍ ବି ଏ କମନ୍ ମିନିଂ ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମିନିଂସ୍ ଓଲ୍ସୋ ମେ ଭେରି ଏକ୍ରସ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ୱାଟ୍ ଷ୍ଟୁଆର୍ଟ ହୋଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ସଟ୍ ଟ୍ରାଇଂ ଟୁ ସେ କହୁଛି ସେଇଥିପାଇଁ ଯେ କି ଦ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସର୍ସ ଟ୍ରାଏ ଟୁ ଫିକ୍ସ ଅ ମିନିଂ ଓର୍ ୱେ ଅଫ୍ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡିଂ ପିପୁଲ୍ ଅର୍ ଇଭେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଟେକ୍ସ ନାଉ question arises that representation is not about whether the media reflects or distorts reality, as this implies that there cannot be any true meaning, but the many meanings that representations can generate. Meaning is constituted by representation, by what is present, what is absent, and what is different. Thus meaning can be contested. ମିନିଂ ମାନେ ନୁହେଁ କି ଖାଲି କ'ଣ ଅଛି କ'ଣ ନାହିଁ ଇଭିନ୍ କ'ଣ ସେଥିରୁ ଭେରିଏସନ୍ସ ହେଉଛି ତେଣୁ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ୱେୟାର୍ ୟୁ ଫାଇଣ୍ଡ ଦ ମିନିଂ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲୱେଜ୍ କଣ୍ଟେଷ୍ଟେଡ୍ ଆମେ କଣ୍ଟେଷ୍ଟ କରୁଛେ ଆଉ ୱି କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଏଗ୍ରି ୱି କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଡିସ୍ଏଗ୍ରି ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ୱାଟ୍ ଷ୍ଟୁଆର୍ଟ ହୋଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ସଟ୍ ଟ୍ରାଇଂ ଟୁ ୱାର୍କ ସେ କହୁଛି ଯେ କି ଏ ରେପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ ଇମ୍ପ୍ଲିକେଟ୍ସ ଦ ଅଡିଏନ୍ସ ଇନ୍ କ୍ରିଏଟିଂ ଇଟ୍ସ ମିନିଂ ପାୱାର୍ ଥ୍ରୁ ଆଇଡିଓଲୋଜି ଓ ବାଇ ଷ୍ଟିରିଓଟାଇପିଂ ସେ କହୁଛି କି through ideology, power, yoda se kuchi, or stereotypes, tries to fix the meaning of a representation, what you call in a preferred meaning. Stuart Holder would a major contribution uchi. What is the most preferred meaning? Which is the most preferred one? Meaning, also in different way. A more effective strategy is to go inside the stereotype and open it up from within to deconstruct the work of representation. ମାନେ ଆମେ ତାକୁ ଡିକନଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଟ କରିବା ଯେଉଁ ମିନିଂ ଅଲରେଡି ଅଛି ଆମେ ତାକୁ ଭାଙ୍ଗିବା ଆମେ ତାକୁ ବୁଝିବାକୁ ଚେଷ୍ଟା କରିବା ଯେ କି କ'ଣ ସେ ମିନିଂ ସେ କହିବାକୁ ଚାହୁଁଛି। ସେ କହୁଛି ଯେ କି କୋଉ ମାନେ ଏନି ଟାଇମ୍ ଏ ପ୍ରୋଡ୍ୟୁସର ଅଫ୍ ଏ ଟେକ୍ସଟ ଏ ପ୍ରୋଡ୍ୟୁସର ଅଫ୍ ଏ ଟେକ୍ସଟ ମାନେ ଆପଣ ଭାବନ୍ତୁ ଯୋଉ ମେସେଜ ଆପଣ ପାଉଛନ୍ତି, ପ୍ରୋଡ୍ୟୁସର କିଏ? ଯିଏ ମିଡ଼ିଆ ପ୍ରଡ଼କ୍ସନ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମରେ ଅଛନ୍ତି, ଯିଏ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରୋଲ କରୁଛି, ଯାହାର ଗୋଟେ ପର୍ପଜ୍ ଅଛି, ସେ କ'ଣ ମେସେଜ ଦେବାକୁ ଚାହୁଁଛି, ସେ ସେଇଟାକୁ ସେ ଫାଇନାଲି ଏଡିଟ୍ କରିକି ସେ ବାହାର କରୁଛି। ଆପଣ ଜାଣିଛନ୍ତି ନା ନାହିଁ? ମାନେ ଇଟ୍ସ ନଟ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ୟୁ ବ୍ଲାଇଣ୍ଡଲି ଗୋ ଆଣ୍ଡ ସୁଟ୍, ୟୁ ଜଷ୍ଟ ବ୍ଲାଇଣ୍ଡଲି ଗୋ ଆଣ୍ଡ ସୁଟ୍। ଆପଣ ଦେଖିବେ ଆପଣ ପ୍ରୋଗ୍ରାମ ବନେଇକି ଆସିଲେ, ଫାଇନାଲି ଏଡିଟିଂ ଟେବୁଲରେ ସେଟା ଏଡିଟ୍ ହେଉଛି, କେଉଁ ପର୍ପଜ୍ରେ ସେ ମେସେଜଟାକୁ ଦେବାର ଅଛି ଆଉ କେଉଁ ଭଳିଆ ତାକୁ ପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟ କରିବାର ଅଛି, ସେଟା ଫାଇନାଲି ଏଡିଟୋରିଆଲ ବୋର୍ଡର ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିପ୍ସନ। ତେଣୁ ଡୋଣ୍ଟ ଥିଙ୍କ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମେସେଜ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ନ୍ୟୁଟ୍ରୋ, ମେସେଜ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଆଟ୍ ଅଲ୍ ନ୍ୟୁଟ୍ରୋ, ମେସେଜ ହ୍ୟାଜ୍ ଏ କନୋଟେସନ, ମେସେଜ ହ୍ୟାଜ୍ ଏ ସବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ ମିନିଂ। ଯିଏ ଏଡିଟିଂ ଟେବୁଲରେ ବସି ଯିଏ ଏଡିଟର ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିପ୍ସନ ସିଏ ଫାଇନାଲାଇଜ୍ କରୁଛି, ସିଏ ଫାଇନାଲାଇଜ୍ କରୁଛି ଯେ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ମେସେଜ ଟୁ ବି ଗିଭେନ୍, ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ମେସେଜ ଟୁ ବି ଗିଭେନ୍, ସେଇ ଯେଉଁ ମେସେଜଟାକୁ ସିଏ ମେସେଜ ପଠାଉଛି, ସେଇ ମେସେଜ ଯେଉଁଟା ଆସୁଛି ତାକୁ ଆମେ ଟେକ୍ସଟ ହିସାବରେ ଦେଖୁଛେ ଆଉ ତାକୁ ଆମେ ଆନାଲାଇଜ୍ କରୁଛେ ଆଉ ତାକୁ ଆମେ କହୁଛେ ଯେ କି ଏଥିରେ କ'ଣ ମିନିଂ ହେଉଛି। ଆମେ ଆମେ ୱି ଆର୍ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ସେଇଙ୍ଗ ଆବାଉଟ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଦେୟାର୍, ବଟ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ମୋଷ୍ଟ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ପର୍ପଜ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଗିଭିଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମେସେଜ, ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ପର୍ପଜ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଗିଭିଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମେସେଜ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହାଉ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମେସେଜ ହାଜ୍ ବିନ୍ ପ୍ୟାକେଜଡ୍, ହାଉ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମେସେଜ ହାଜ୍ ବିନ୍ ପ୍ରୋଡ୍ୟୁସଡ୍, ହାଉ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମେସେଜ ହାଜ୍ ବିନ୍ ସର୍କୁଲେଟେଡ୍, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ୱି ନିଡ୍ ଟୁ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡିମିଷ୍ଟିଫାଇ ଦ ଆଇଡ଼ିଆଜ୍ ବିହାଇଣ୍ଡ ପ୍ରୋଡକ୍ସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମେସେଜ। ଆଇ ହୋପ୍ ସେଇ କଣ୍ଟେକ୍ସରେ ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଦେଖିବା ଆମେ ପାଇବା ଯେ କି ଏନି ଟାଇମ୍, ମୁଁ ଯେଉଁ କହିଲି ଯେ କି ଏନି ଟାଇମ୍ ଏ ପ୍ରୋଡ୍ୟୁସର ଅଫ୍ ଏ ଟେକ୍ସ ଟ୍ରାଇଜ୍ ଟୁ ଫିକ୍ସ ଅ ମିନିଂ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ପର୍ସନ୍ ଓ ଇଭେଣ୍ଟ, ଦିସ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ୟୁଜୁଆଲି ୱାଟ୍ ୟୁ ସେ ରିଭିଲ୍ ଭ୍ୟୁ ପଏଣ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ବାୟସ୍ ଦେଟ୍ ମେ ବି ପଲିଟିକାଲ ଆର୍ ଅଦରୱାଇଜ୍। ୟୁଜୁଆଲି ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ପେପର୍ସ ଆପଣ ଦେଖିବେ ଆଟେମ୍ପ୍ଟ ଟୁ ଡେମୋନାଇଜ୍ ଗ୍ରୁପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପିପୁଲ, ସେମାନେ ବହୁତ ଲୋକଙ୍କୁ ଡେମୋନାଇଜ୍ କରିବାକୁ ଚେଷ୍ଟା କରନ୍ତି। ଆଣ୍ଡ ହାଉ ଏଭର ଏଣ୍ଟି ଷ୍ଟିରିଓଟିପିକାଲ ରେପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଟ୍ରାଇଜ୍ ଟୁ ଫିକ୍ସ ମିନିଂ ଟୁ। So these groups of people who were demonized in some paper might be presented as heroes in others. apan dekhibe jodi gotiya tv channel re ajika condition desaro ea hichi jodi gotiya set of tv tv channel gotiya type ro story dewa chesta korchi onyo tv channel guda sabu alaga type ra taku present korchanti। So now you can understand, I think today is a better context to understand that there is no uniformity in message or a text. In fact, it has different ways of presentation of text or different ways of they are being presented or represented in the media itself. So there is no uniformity in that sense when you look at media and say that why media has been presented in a particular way. Of course, media, but there is a larger political economy behind it. So political economy, ସେ ହେଉଛି ଗୋଟେ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ, ଜଣେ ସେ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନକୁ ଓନ୍ କରୁଛି, ଜଣେ ସେ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନକୁ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରୋଲ କରୁଛି, ତାର ଗୋଟେ ପର୍ପଜ୍ ଅଛି, ସେ କେଉଁ ଟାଇପ୍ର ମେସେଜ୍ ଦେବାକୁ ଚାହିଁବ। ସେଇ କଣ୍ଟେକ୍ସଟରେ ଆପଣ ଯେତେ ମିଡ଼ିଆରେ ମେସେଜ୍ ଦେଖୁଛନ୍ତି, ଦେ ଆର୍ ନେଭର୍ ନ୍ୟୁଟ୍ରୋ। ଗୋଟେ ଇଣ୍ଟରେଷ୍ଟିଂ ଦଜ୍ ଏ ଭେରି ଇଣ୍ଟରେଷ୍ଟିଂ ଷ୍ଟେଟମେଣ୍ଟ ଗିଭେନ୍ ବାଇ ଏ ଭେରି ସିନିୟର ଡିପ୍ଲୋମାଟ୍। ସେ କହିଲେ କି ୱେନ୍ ଆଇ ସି ଏ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ପେପର୍, ୱେନ୍ ଆଇ ସି ଏ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ପେପର୍ there are three things I see in a newspaper. se kahile je ki mu je gole newspaper dekhe tin ta jinsu mu paaye newspaper re kon se kahile there is truth, there is semi truth, and rest are all lies in newspaper. se kahile tin ta jinsu, there is truth, there is semi truth, and rest are all lies in the newspaper. Now let me come back। ଏଇ ଯେଉଁ ତିନିଟା ଜିନିଷ ଟ୍ରୁଥ, ସେମି ଟ୍ରୁଥ, ଲାଇଜ୍, ସେ କହିଲେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ମୁଁ ସ୍ପୋର୍ଟସ୍ କଲମ୍ ଦେଖେ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ପେପରରେ, ଆଇ ଫାଇଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍ ଇନ୍ ଇଟ୍। କିଏ କେତେ ଗୋଲ୍ ମାରିଲା, କିଏ କେତେ କ୍ରିକେଟ୍ ସ୍କୋର କଲା, ହଁ କେଉଁଠି କେତେ କିଏ ଇଏ କଲା, ସେଗୁଡ଼ା ହେଉଛି ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍। ସେ କହିଲେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ମୁଁ ୱେଦର କଲମ୍ ଦେଖେ, ମୁଁ ଦେଖେ ଯେ ସେମି ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍, କାହିଁକିନା ୱେଦର ଇଜ୍ ଅଲୱେଜ୍ ଏ ପ୍ରେଡିକ୍ସନ୍, ୟୁ ନୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ୱି ଆର୍ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ଫୋରକାଷ୍ଟିଂ ୱେଦର। We are not sure about weather. We are actually forecasting weather. We are sort of trying to know, we are predicting the possibilities of weather. And rest are all lies in newspaper. I hope now you understand what I intended to say, that there is truth, there is semi-truth, and rest are all lies in a newspaper. That is how we sort of try to understand, because these are not news, these are actually views. So you should understand that when you see, similarly, when you see today television, you find that the kind of visuals, and gradually these visuals have replaced the words, the text. So gradually the society is becoming, we are more and more, we are moving towards a visual culture, imagistic society. We are trying to more and more familiarize ourselves. But we are not a part of a visual culture. We are not a part of visual. I'm a oral society. So we love to chat, talk. Segudako ajikal media nahi galani. So you say social media chatting. So you're using those terms today. But what I'm saying is the exposure to the visual, so that you understand the visual. We do not have a proper understanding of the visual in our societies, because we can't. Sethipai, even Marshall McLuhan jatala kouchi, ki medium is the message. So that Marshall McLuhan jatala kouchi, the medium is the message. He is actually trying to collapse between the content and the form. Apan bhavantu, television, message of television through asuchi. See, television is a platform. That through a message to asuchi. Okay, there is a content and there is a form. So your message to asuchi, that is the content, and television is the form. See, kuchi jagi, medium is the message. Tamane, he's collapsing between the content and the form. I hope you understand what I'm trying to explain. See, kuchi, the medium is the message. So the question arises that it doesn't allow you to think. All your imagination is getting reused. All your possibilities of thinking gets collapsed. It says that don't question television. Whatever comes in television, just abide by it. So that's what medium is the message. Aku gudai criticize haichi world sara. Aku gudai criticize haichi loko koile, scholars koile. It is medium is not message, it is massage. Because there are a lot of scholars have written that what he talks about is all rubbish. He has no understanding about, except that he's playing with the words, and that is how he's sort of trying to talk about extension of television becomes a medium to extend all your ideas. But there are problematics, there are issues, which is also there when McLuhan sort of trying to write about medium is the message. But the whole idea is it is trying to reuse your imagination and representation. What comes is real. It is not that he's sort of trying to say that what comes through television screen, just believe it, just focus on it. Today, there are, like, we are living in a postmodernist era. We are saying that we live in a time when we say about collapse of sex. Apana jodi MTV music sunuthwe, apana dekhiba gorai jo music video research hochi, jo pop music, jo MTV ra asuchi, jo message asuchi, apana dekhiba je ki sethare ye idea asuchi ki just everything has collapsed in the system. Can you hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. Everything has collapsed. Apana dekhiba we are talking about unisexuality, and there is a collapse of sex. There is a collapse of common sense and sense. How is it possible? How is it possible that today common sense and sense have mixed together? There is no distinctions. What you see is common sense. Is you make a sense? Age of postmodernist readings we asila say context re ame critique koruche. आमे कहूचे कि जो टेलीविजन रे देखा जाउची सोसाइटी इज बिकमिंग मोर एंड मोर विजुअलिस्टिक फ्रॉम अ वर्ड्स इट इज बिकमिंग मोर इमेजिस्टिक फ्रॉम अ वर्ड्स इट हैज बिकम इमेजिस्टिक आपण देखिबे ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम आग्रेतले दूरदर्शन ने न्यूज रीडर वाज ट्राइंग टू रीड अ न्यूज पे अ टेलीविजन चैनल यूज्ड टू सब्सटेंशिएट विद अ विजुअल क्यूज बट टुडे वी डोंट नीड इट द न्यूज रीडर गोस टू द बैकग्राउंड And rather, it's more and more visual speaks about it. But visuals have a tendency to hide. Visuals have a tendency to overpower the words itself. But most of the times, the visual, what you see, you may not agree, you may disagree. We do not have in our society a proper media literacy or media education where actually people can decipher meanings by reading the visual itself. Now, I use a term called reading. What does it mean? Now, when I say reading, the how is reading different from watching? How is reading different from watching? Reading is a much more an active engagement. Like I'm reading a text, I'm reading a book, I'm watching a movie. So semantically or semiotically, when I say that I'm reading a book, I'm actually actively engaged with the book to decode the meanings which is there in the text. Meanings kuda already encoded in the text. Now, for instance, conventionally, watching, when you say it's a passive, I said the passive categories, that images, messages are given and I'm watching. But now I'm actively reading the messages. Actively reading, but I'm reading. Meanings are already encoded in the book. Now, for instance, conventional notion of communication, when you say, you always talk about there is a source and there is a receiver. Message is in between and there is a receiver. Right? Audience. Receiver, you call it, or an audience, you call it. Source to a receiver or an audience. But when I'm saying reading, that process doesn't work. It's actually generation of meaning. I mean, I can look at a sky. I can look at a sky and I can recite a poetry. I can see a flower. I can also recite a poem. What does it mean? I can also extract meaning, which is already there. By seeing the cloud, by seeing the rose, I can also make meaning. For instance, I give you an example of Apana Atlas Dipchandi. I mean, choto vadaru school re amko training diya hotla how to read an atlas. Kana sethre jo symbols dikhe, all are encoded in the atlas itself. Now thole in the below in the picture, you find that all instructions are written there. It's called temple, roads, canals, waterways, railway lines. Sabu guda sabu atlas re sabu achhi. See atlas book ta ko mu nahi ki jauchi. There is nobody there to tell me that how to read an atlas. I'm reading myself and I'm trying to decode meanings from that text. Similarly, a television message hala ki you can see any other you can see any other text hala messages sabu bade encoded hi kachi apan bhabantu pratyek dino. When you are walking on the streets, you are going driving in your car, you see various messages are there already encoded and they're all illustrated on the billboards, kiosk, adverts. They're all texts. And we are trying to decipher meanings and trying to understand those texts. So when we are now talking about meaning, the representations, we are saying that there are different ways that how these representations are being encoded and being presented in the media itself. So now I need to get back to the idea of what is a conventional notion of representation and what are the other ways of, what is a new way of looking at representations. So representation as reflection or distortion of reality. Representation as reflection or distortion of reality. Eta ko apan kichhi koibe ki bhai ei jo representation apan dekhuchanti seta hochi reflection or kichhi koibe ki eta hochi distortion of reality. Because the word has a kind of a double meaning. Apan dekhibe ethire double meaning achi. Ethire apankar reflection bhi achi, distortion bhi achi. Even in its common sense understanding, it does mean to present, to image, to depict, or to offer a depiction of something else. And the word representation or representation does sort of carry with it the notion that something was there already, and though the media has been represented. Nevertheless, this notion that somehow representation represents a meaning which is already there is a very common idea. And on the other hand, one of the ideas that we can try to subvert. So we can say that in common sense meaning, try to take it back to a little bit, we can say that there are other understanding of the word representation, which also plays a role in what we bring to the topic, because we speak of political figures upon a political representation. Representation has been used upon a census. Census ta kon mu kahibi je apan ko pacharibi je how do you look at census? How do you look at census? Census is a text which represents population. Bujhle? So the question is, I don't need to, if I want to know about India population, then I need to look at census, the tables. Then a conventional notion re apan dekhibe representation is an art. Representation of art of presenting my ideas and thoughts in a particular way. In fact, very interestingly, Jack Goody is a very, very important, eminent anthropologist. In fact, Jack Goody ra kamo hela apan goro orality upare, literacy upare. Se kamo korichi je orality ru literacy ko je tole society shift koruchi. Move koruchi orality to literacy. I mean, primarily we were oral societies. Face-to-face interaction, dialogue, our communication, exchanges. Suddenly apan dekhibe je ki ame literate society ko jauche. Mane moro thesis ra mu kaam karuthili ki along with literacy, apan sunan deta very carefully, along with literacy, illiterates were born. जो समय आपण लिटरेसी इंट्रोड्यूस करैले सोसाइटी रे जो माने सोशली लिटरेट थिले तांकू आपण भी टेक्निकली इलिटरेट भाव रे डिक्लेअर कर देले कारण लिटरेसी इज अ टेक्निक इज अ एबिलिटी टू रीड एंड राइट पीपल मे नॉट हैव इट सो नाउ सडनली व्हेन यू इंपोज दिस लिटरेसी अ लार्ज सेक्शन ऑफ पीपल बिकम इलिटरेट्स इन सोसाइटीज आज भी सेया तेणु आम जो लिटरेसी ओरालिटी एटा हूँ सब डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ मीडिया लिटरेसी इन दैट सेंस इज ऑल्सो ए काइंड ऑफ ए स्किल इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ मीडिया एंड टुडे वी आर मूविंग टुवर्ड्स अ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ स्किल दैट इज सोशल मीडिया राइट नाउ व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सोशल मीडिया द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस दैट इज मूविंग फ्रॉम अ ओरल टू ए काइंड ऑफ ए सोशल मीडिया इट्स अ लॉन्ग शिफ्ट In the process, you find there is a skilling and de-skilling process. There is a skilling and de-skilling process. In my lifetime, I must have learned different kinds of literacy skills. And today, gradually, the more I'm getting older, probably I am trying to now cope myself up with social media and trying to learn skills. Imagine those were aged people. How many skill sets they must have tried to skill and de-skill in the entire process. Aji etwara me taku kahuche ki na se social media ta anguli chaluni. Because it's all finger touch. Because today we are moving towards a skill which is all finger touch in a mobile. So most of the times I write something which goes in a wrong way. Because it's a question of coping up with social media. So in that person, skilling. Upon Chris Bailey's Bohi Jota, Empire and Information, it's a very classic book. And it is a must for everybody to read so that you understand in a historical context, jo jinsodamu kohuchi, jo knowledge communicator katha kohuchan, the Brahmins who were actually the knowledge, who had the repository of knowledge, and they were the communicator of knowledge. And information. How gradually from a sacred, it's more and more secularization of communication and information. Sitapurpura social order pratar kamo. Chris Bailey is a very eminent historian and he worked in India. Then see apango solo so satabdiru apango se dava India ra entire historical archaeological material jo basis ra se kouchi the skilling aur diskilling kemiti chalichi colonialism samare bhi jo art jo representation ra thila je mohari ra lekhutla aji suddenly apano computerized jamanara asila pore apan khali agree or disagree karuchanti you do not read you are not reading you are not reading apan khali agree dabai 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 ki finally you are waiting that finally when you are opening your account in social media or Google or Twitter or whatever kintu colonialism somere se jo peskar thila baragacha tole basi se jo draft karuthila kete loko bujhutile je se kon se lekhuche kintu samasta bujhil kon se lekhi dala jothre ki mo khalas hai gelibo so the art you see the whole question is being what I'm trying to tell about standardization so today computer has standardized it you don't need to bother much to write it struggle to write it now there is a standardized message which is encrypted there you have to just click it and say agree or disagree so you find there is a shift which has taken place if let's forget about whether we read the message or not we don't read invariably because we are interested in the end product that is opening my account in Google Mail I'm not interested in what the you know copyrights issues or what are privacy issues what are the security issues I'm less bothered about it I'm interested more in the out product out I'm an outcome of it but the art of writing it had its charisma it had its following in societies that is what is a written culture what you call literacy a written culture had in our societies so let's not overthrow it because it also remained for centuries all of you know as a caste society it remained to a higher caste then it subsequently came to a twice born caste then today is scheduled caste which are a very recent entry to have access to education kali jo mate so apan question pocharthule ki mu kahi ki why should I be responsible for what my grandparents did mu kahuchi je literacy which was monopolized by the upper castes for centuries you have only given them chance for 60-70 years so that also it makes you absolutely jittery but you monopolize you exercise power through literacy because knowledge is power anyway so what I'm trying to say is that how in these societies the representations matter so now because we lack a media education in our society what apparently we see the text what we read we are basically interested to understand the meanings Stuart Hall ketole bi representation bisaretole Stuart Hall kouchi he is not trying to make an ultimate meaning of it he says that these meanings may be contested but we have to understand that what meaning you have to go behind the screen to know why the message has been depicted in that way unless you deconstruct you cannot engage you cannot understand what is the hidden intention behind what is the hidden intention behind mu apanku dui ta kahile se jo use user kahile trutiya ta hala usage mane apan aji dekhibe aji apan mane jo generation the generation in which you are also giving your customized messages and now social media gives you that freedom to also customize respond reply and produce you are a co-producer of message mane apan bi sei bhalia message ku co-produce karuchanti seita apan jetola ame kali next class ra ame voices bisare kahiba marginal voices that will be much more interesting to know that in what way it is not merely a meaning making it is much beyond that it is even those meanings are being used to transform and act upon and engage in intervention So that will be a different stage. That will be a different stage. So this representation, when you are using, don't put so many ideas into the basket. It is actually sort of trying to decipher meaning and trying to understand what actually messages are. We were talking about that representation as reflection or distortion of reality. And now we say that this word has a kind of double meaning. Even in its common sense understanding, it does mean to present, to image, to depict, to offer a depiction of something else. And the word representation or representation does sort of carry with it the notion that something was already there. Something was already there and through the media has been represented. Nevertheless, this notion that somehow representation represents a meaning which is already there is a very common idea. And on the other hand, one of the ideas that we would like to subvert. So we give a common sense meaning and try to take it back a little bit in what we are trying to say in this particular today's discussions. But then there is another understanding of the word representation, which also plays Mujoda Kohli, geopolitical representation, idea of representation, Amitra Kouche, because the people whom we elect and send them, they are also our representatives. And where we can't be, they can be. So the notion of something which images and depicts and that which stands in for something else, both of these ideas are kind of brought together in the notion of representation. Upon Bujiparthwe, Amethole representation, our political representation, our so-called elected MPs and MLAs, they represent on behalf of us. They represent on behalf of us, whether to parliament or here. So that is also another meaning. So the representation is the way in which meaning is somehow. Representation is the way in which meaning is somehow given to the things which are depicted through the images or whatever it is on screens or the words on a page which stand for what we are talking about. And if you think that the meaning that it is giving is a very different from a kind of distortion of what really means, then our work on representation would be in measuring that gap between what one might think of as the true meaning or an event or an object and how it is presented in the media. And there's a lot of very good work in media studies, which you can see in exactly like this. Both detailed, intense Kama Hichi media studies. In fact, apanoda bahut interesting bohi by Todd Jitlin to dekhibe. It's called The Whole World is Watching. The Whole World is Watching. Kamada actually America New Left Movement when it started. New Left Movement when it started. Say somewhere Todd Jitlin is a very leading Berkeley media sociologist. Say frame wise, the television upon got a frame achieve. Say analyze koriki bit by bit, sort of try to decode the meaning. So koilaki New Left Movement America fail hegala. It could not succeed. It could not succeed. So, kahi ki se success halani? Even apan kora Watergate spying scandal, Nixon upare joda hichi. Taupare bhi interesting kamo varilani. Kemiti media can go to such an extent. Je ete taku television re time and again ete uchali was mane ete se media message debe. Ye loko finally. Disgusted hejibe. Heiki finally, mane literally Nixon had to resign and to leave White House. Seiti apana India re sebhala kamo hei nahi bartan suda. Amar unfortunately, ame sebhala rigorous kamo korune. Apana Bofors scandal. Apana jodi kiye, some of you will be interested. One should take the Bofors scandal jatale ete bino dua. Ite mane taku challa Rajiv Gandhi against re challa mane ghano ghano television debates hala. Finally Bofors sir hala kon? What is the outcome of Bofors? Mane television kemiti taku continuously taku gote time re bane taku ritimata taku kala. Ultimately it failed, it miserably. So media can boomerang as well. Sometimes it can affect, sometimes it can also boomerang. It have both the ways. So what we basically try to study, that there are different ways that. I would have very interesting example, Devi. It's a very famous book. It's actually a book on television serial. It's called How to Read Donald Duck. Is a very, very interesting book. It actually Latin American context where Armand Matlat is another very eminent sociologist, media scholar. Bahut leki chandi apno Armand Matlat ro bohi dekhibe classic. In fact, it's called there are duita edited volume which is classic like a Bible. Ame kouche communication and class struggle. There are duita volume hochi. So Armand Matlat aur Sajay Sizlour aur Sia ta wife Michelle Matlat and Armand Matlat je se samare Chile re thela gudai lekhichi media movements world communication bahut lekhichi. Armand Matlat has written immensely. Armand Matlat to Chile re se study karichi jethole America re satellites guda so they are making satellites in US and sort of trying to launch it to Latin America. You all of you know that America had always a lot of interest in Latin America and intervened. So through satellites, in fact, they transformed Latin America. You find they intervened in the Latin American internal politics as well. Kemiti continuously America ru message gala jege guda sabu drug rulers, drug mafias, ministers guda, president guda tanku overthrow karo. How it went against them. So that is the context which you see in Latin America it happened. But anyway, I'm talking about this book. It's called How to Read Donald Duck. This is a very powerful book. Imagine, Donald Duck is a creation in the United States as a comic strip. It was created in the United States. And It was televised. And so that now in Latin America, the children are watching Donald Duck. Mane Latin America re chua gora sabu Donald Duck dekhuchanti. Donald Duck dekhi, tankara distant dream re, ko bhalia behave karibe, ko bhalia taku sapnare dream re kemiti se bang, 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 kemiti scream korchanti, shout korchanti, how unconsciously say they are behaving. So to Armand Matlat kohuchi, jo purpose of the manufacturer, producer of the text, jie se text produce korichi, that is Donald Duck, taku television through re pateichi, au jie taku consume koruchi in different cultural contexts. Apan bhavun to America, yeta huchi Latin America. Or even different world re chua amaro Latin America, Donald Duck को अपनो receive कर चुन्दे. सही context है. जतरा अपनो देखिवे जे कि जिए produce करुची, अब जिए consume करुची, सीए ताको घोटे perspective रे देखुची, जतरा से text का consume ही गला, ता purpose is fulfilled. माने मुँह गुडे जिन्सो बिक्रिया को चाहुची, मुँह गुडे idea को बिक्रिया को चाहुची. So idea ko mu different format re kori taku mu seta ko display korli taku mu media re chadili taku loko consume kale taku etole consume kale si dekhuchi gotia angle ru ki jetole consume hela mor purpose fulfill he gala. So that is one strand of looking at. I'm not saying that is the end of the story. So any crude consumer political economist would like to look at that how the producer of the text and the consumer of the text is fulfilled. Anyway, so now Ame Bartan, dekhiye a new view. I will finish it up within another 5-10 minutes so that I can respond to the questions. I believe there are so many questions. So question answers are much better. Tano representation Ame tolo kouche, jikise kouche ki Stuart Hall se kouche, The truth is that cultural studies, a great deal of media studies work that the notion of representation is regarded as too literal and too straightforward. And the reason for that is because we want to ask the question of whether events, the meaning of people, groups, and what they're doing, etc., whether these things do have any one essential, fixed, or true meaning against which we could measure, or it were the level of distortion in the way in which they're represented. Manakorandu, suppose one says, yes, I can see the people are meeting now in somewhere to discuss about a particular corona situation, but what it means, what is the meaning of that meeting, is a very complicated thing to decide. We have to know not only the whole history of what led up to, you would have to know what each of the participants wants out of it. You have to also know some assessment of what the consequences of what the event are likely to be before you could say. So what is the meaning? And we all know absolutely clearly one thing, you could be certain of it, that there will be never be one interpretation of what is going on this particular issue. It will always be a contested question. There will never be a finally settled, fixed meaning. The one thing you can say about those events is that there is no one true fixed meaning about it. We say that this is in a way, we're also saying now is that representation does not really capture the process at all, because there was nothing absolutely fixed that in the first place to represent. Of course, there was something. People are meeting, they're talking. When there is a television news shows about exchange of files between different countries, when there is a program being shown on Prime Minister signing a deal or a contract, we don't know exactly what is there inside the contract. We don't know actually what are the discussions behind it. And we only see the outcome of it. And that is what is being media sort of trying to represent about a particular deal. So that is incomplete. So now we say that when we're talking about representation, not as an after the event activity, after the event activity, it means something and then the presentation might change or distort the meaning. We are talking about the fact that it has no fixed meaning, no real meaning in the obvious sense until it has been represented. And the representation, since they're likely to be very different as we move from one person to another, one group to another, one part of society or another, you find there is just as those forms of representation. Now, this means is, in fact, the process of representation has entered into the event itself. In a way, it does not exist meaningfully until it has been represented. So this is what you want to understand, that it is a part of the object itself. It is constitutive. It is one of its conditions of existence. And therefore, I would like to end here by saying that representation is not outside the event, not after the event, but within the event itself. It is constitutive of it. Any message ku apana itale dekhuchanti television re ki marginals ku dekhuchanti, whether it is a Dalits or gender or class or a region or religion, you need to understand the way I said it. The entire process is constitutive, and that is called representation. I'll just stop here. We can have questions. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
There are some questions.
Yeah,
and I hope the learners benefit from the lecture.
Yeah.
And sir has talked extensively on representation, the actual meaning of representation. He has talked about publics. He has introduced new terms like prosumer. Medium is the message and how it was taken by the critics and the scholars. And so these are very, very abstract concepts and normally difficult to understand, but I guess sir has tried his level best to bring them to normal understanding. So I mean, Bhabuchu, the learners mane through benefited here. Now I'll take up the questions one by one.
Yeah, yeah. Please.
There are some questions, but I think I'll be doing justice if I club two or more questions.
Yeah.
So there is a question on stereotypes. The learner wants to know what is a stereotype, how media represents the stereotypes, and the same learner also wants to know whether Dalits have been stereotyped in media, and why is it that media is not able to freely express Dalits and their problems before the world.
I think first of all you need to understand what do you mean by media. I think you have given a benefit of doubt to media. You say, why is media? Which media are you referring to? Which media are you talking about? Who controls it? Who owns it? Is it a free media? Is it a media which is largely concerned about society, public, people? I think we have completely forgotten our understanding of media. I'll tell you why this question or the way of articulating such question is coming. The simple reason is we are still in a welfareist mode. Ame bartan sudha media bisare tole ame kotharta huche ame our entire imagination is in a welfareist mode. Welfareist mode mane state mane ame bhauche je media is a public good. Amar jemti alaga good achi social good achi ame media ku bi bhauche je gota public good. But media should do this. Media should do that. Why media is not doing? This is the kind of a query comes only in a welfare societies. Because state subsidized media. State media is accountable to the state. In that context, when the question arises, then obviously you have every right to raise this question. But you are forgetting that you do not live anymore in a welfare state. You do not live anymore in a welfare state. Post 90s, 1990 Porotu, media is a completely marketplace of ideas. Media is a completely a marketplace of ideas. Hence, your understanding and vision should change. Amaro jo complete jo notion of press as a fourth estate jo jinsota, we have to debunk, we have to critically engage by saying that press does not anymore function like a fourth estate. It itself is a very vibrant actor. Press has to survive in the market. Press also has to, media has to survive in the market. So democracy of media as a relation, democracy of media as a relation, we have always looked at in a very normative way. Media should do this, media should do that. But everything media should do, tekanichi democracy. Media tekanichi. I mean, democracy can violate itself, democracy can go in either way, but media should not. Media should do this. এই যে জিনিসটা কিন্তু আজি যে মিডিয়ার হালত হয়েছে মিডিয়া হ্যাজ কমপ্লিটলি ডিলিঙ্কড ইটসেলফ কমপ্লিটলি নাও বিকজ দ্য কাইন্ড অফ মিডিয়া হ্যাজ কেম আপ অ্যান্ড ইন ফ্যাক্ট ওয়েদার ইটস অ্যানাদার স্টোরি ওয়েদার ইউ সে দ্যাট দ্যার ইজ আ ডিমাইজ অফ দ্য মিডিয়াম অর নট দ্যাটস আ ডিফারেন্ট স্টোরি বাট ওয়েন ইউ আর টকিং অ্যাবাউট মিডিয়া ইউ আর অলসো ট্রাইং টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দ্যাট টুডে ইউ ক্যানট এক্সপেক্ট ইন ফ্যাক্ট For that, you need a very strong public service. You need a strong welfare state. So in that sense, you are sort of trying to say that how media should behave and media, what should be the role of media. But now what I'm saying is we have measurably failed about doing it. Now the question is media has to survive in the market. And again, who controls media? Again, a section of people look at obviously the higher castes, obviously upper castes. And also those who are educated, elites, they're controlling media. And obviously you will not expect. And secondly, why a Dalit? Imagine who is the media dekhuchike? Who is the major audience of the media? Again, upper caste. Again, not Dalits. Now, why any upper caste should be interested to see a message about Dalit? Or even a Dalit story? Why they will be interested to see? Nobody will be interested to see a Dalit. What happens to Dalit? Why I'm in a comfortable place? Why should I be? So the question is, we live in a private zone and we expect a private zone where a media has to earn its revenue for its own survival. And you ask that I will do a charity by giving on marginals or even a Dalit. Why should I give it on Dalit? because that will not generate my revenue. Why should I give it? I would rather give more some emotional stories and serials so that more and more people will watch my television channel, because I'm also struggling for viewership. I'm also struggling for TRP, and Dalit will not get me TRP at all. So why should I bother about it, Dalit? Why should I bother about it? This is only possible. This is only possible when we talk about a public service media. This is only possible when we talk about the public service media. So I think our understanding, very foundation, our perspectives need to differ when we talk about our media and politics. That today, you find that media is another actor like politics. So media is creating itself. So media has completely taken a command, and it's just independent unit today. It is no more dependent anymore. So media has to now create. Media has to mediate. Media has to create in that sense. So media has to survive in the market, has to generate its revenue. So media is more concerned about whom to show and whom not to show. So they prioritize. They prioritize what to show and what not to show. But if you have been a public service media, as an audience, as a citizen, I have a right over a public service media to say that why Dalit is missing, why children are missing, why disabled are missing, why gender is missing, why even marginals are missing, why they're not represented in the media. I have every question. I have every question to the government, provided I have a media is accountable to me. Provided media is accountable to me. Media is not accountable to me at all as a citizen. Media is independent. Media is not accountable to me. In England, you find that BBC takes a taxes, that takes a kind of a taxes on the listenerships, viewerships. So we are paying subscription fee for watching a black and white, watching a colored TV, watching a radio, watching all kinds of stuff. We are paying money for watching BBC. So BBC is accountable, and BBC presents its budget in the parliament in terms of each and every expenditure BBC does in the parliament. So that is where BBC is accountable. So our public service broadcasting, our Doordarshan, our media is not accountable at all. So you have no rights to ask to local commercial channels that why they should show. Because even though you say they are not interested in saying, because their first priority is basically projecting for survive their own survival and their own existence. So obviously, you can't expect a market to follow the logic of society and community. Market has to decide its own idea of society and community. Market has to do profit making. Market has to do survival itself. So they have to survive in the market where already there is a jungle, Darwinian jungle. There are so many channels, and they have to survive for their viewership. They have to also drag the audience for more and more should look at their channels. So the question of competition. Competition is a process of elimination. So here, elimination of caste, community, and society altogether. Okay, next.
So maybe what you said applies to the corporate media, but why can't an average citizen of India, why can't an average citizen of India ask these questions to Doordarshan, All India Radio, as to why the market is? So the question would
have... Corporate,
after corporatization of media, maybe you can say that media is independent. Media decides what is commercially beneficial for it or not. But in the present context, why can't these questions be asked to a channel like Doordarshan or All India Radio, which are actually public channels and which are accountable to us as citizens? We pay taxes for this.
Absolutely. No, I'm a tax donor. Doordarshan ko hame tax donor. We have stopped giving taxes after 77. The subscription no thale, viewer subscription no thale. So they have stopped it. So the question is, because they stopped subscription, so they are not accountable at all. So the question is, they're not accountable, but still then you have every right, because if it is a public service media, they are accountable to you because they are public service. After all, the public revenue which is being invested in Doordarshan and radio. So they are accountable to represent our communities and society and culture. So say context, still you find as studies, you detailed studies are to be done, even though it has been done, the Doordarshan did much better than the corporate television. Doordarshan did much better than the corporate television. At least Doordarshan presents, Doordarshan represents to a large section, to a diverse audience, in comparison with commercial channels. So we know it very well. See, the question is, after all, Doordarshan also has lost its ground because of the competition environment in the television sector in India. It has lost its viewership. What don't you think what has happened in 30 years? Doordarshan has remarkably lost its viewership. If you look at the initial arrangement since 90s, if you'll see the initial arrangement, Star TV and Doordarshan came together, because you see, these are private channels. They have not invested much in infrastructure, which Doordarshan has invested. Aparna, when you were saying all the HPT and LPTs, high power transmitter, low power transmitter, opening up television infrastructures across the states, because that was a public service. So it had to do it. It had to reach out to the larger congregations. Aparna aji kahibe, it's a very interesting, because Northeast hala, jete conflict areas hala, all these areas you'll find that government knows very well that it will not generate much revenue from these areas. The tenu, city kuda ete high power transmitter dawa kichi justification nahi. Kintu, jota border area, jo bada conflict area like Jammu and Kashmir, you'll find that the government will give a high power transmitter, but not in northeast side. The karano, kena northeast lo basic revenue government pakku asiyara prashna uthuni. Kena segudanku oda low power transmitter dele vitoliya jao. Tumhe say low power transmitter has no meaning. But when you talk about Kashmir and other areas, there are high power transmitters. Why? You are not only concerned to give to the border areas means, not only to the people about creating and generating a public opinion, even crossing the border, across the border, people are watching to your television. Aponaji, government never had a vision plan about it. Pakistan did much better in television than India. In fact, if you go to entire Jammu and Kashmir areas, people watch PTV. People watch PTV. Hardly people watched Doordarshan, because PTV had better cultural programs. Forget about. Then say context re. Apna dekhiye jo border areas re jo conflict hoche, jete samay apna spend koribe gote particular channel re, you are not only watching entertainment. In the process, you are also consuming news. I can put you into a medium. I also make it sure that you are watching to the news. I'll give you a very interesting example about Second World War. These are research studies which I'm talking about. Jazz music, all of you know about the jazz music, which was actually played, it was highly popular in Germany. And imagine that when Nazism was in power, the Nazis were very critical about jazz. A, it was played by the blacks, listened by the Jews. We must scrap jazz music altogether. Jethole samane jazz ko ban kordele in when they banned jazz music in radio, so people moved away from German radio and listen to the Allies radio stations. It's not only you are listening to music, along with that you are also consuming news. So gradually people lost interest in the news itself. Similarly, I'll also tell you that in India, if you look at the conflicts which occurred during colonial period, the German radio the way they propagated about anti-British propaganda they made during Second World War, basically saying that people should not join radio, people should people should not join the army, British army, and the conditions of Indians in the war fields and the survival questions and eating human flesh and the kind of rumors which they propagated through the radio. In fact, it totally, you find there was a total, there was a decline in the readership or listenership of British radio in India itself. So I'm saying that, you know, how it can play a different roles in societies. There are a lot of interesting work on the music, the context where you find the scholarship which is there. And question is, now you ask about reviving. Now suddenly you find all of us are talking about that this is a time that we need to revive. Ajiju health ro condition hichi, public health ro ajiju because of this whole coronavirus. We are now seriously realizing that if we would have strengthened our public health, probably we would have been in a much better condition like any other part of the world. And that is a pity that now we are realizing and sort of trying to reinvent this whole idea of public health. And similarly, a day will come where we will talk about re-strengthening our idea of public service. Partham the public service ko loko bhuli yalani. Kana 90s pare, jo se public service ro concept 77 re, janta party tar political manifesto ko ani ki ame autonomy kariba, public service build kariba, that collapsed completely. It's for the notion, it's a kind of a skeleton without flesh and blood. We have a public service which has no meaning at all. So it does not have, like in BBC, in other parts of the Europe where you find there is a very strong, vibrant public service. And they're really concerned about society, culture, diversities, which we have completely missed the bus. So the question doesn't arise, or even an argument has no meaning if we say that why the state is not doing. State is not. State has made, left the media to the private hands completely. So we should be. Even what is there in Doordarshan, it is also trying to compete with the market. Otherwise, it will not survive in the market itself. Apanko MTNL ro avastha se aichi. Ajikali look out ke MTNL re JV deichi se immediately withdraw kar deichi. Kahiki. Completely it has collapsed. Because it's a state which is responsible. You have to understand that state has failed us. So, you know, this is where we need to talk about that the state has to strengthen it. We are not hitting the direct point. Rather, we are just playing on the sidekicks and talking about why it is happening. It's all rubbish. It has no meaning. The state has to do it. State, we need to strengthen the state. And we need to radicalize the state by saying that state must ensure, whether it is a Dalit, whether it is a caste issue, it should be brought to the public galore. Okay, next.
So there are two questions. I'll club them. There is a question from Shwetlisha Subradarshini from Baleswar, and there is a question from Babula Pradhan. Shwetlisha wants to know that non-representation of truth by the media, does it not hamper the media credibility? She writes, why people believe the media? She's talking about media credibility. So does it indirectly not affect the media credibility? And there is another question which can be answered at the same year. Marginalization of media communication impact the... So what the learner wants to know that ignoring the marginalized communities, the media ignoring of the marginalized communities, does it not indirectly or does it not in the long run increase the poverty, the inequality, and the social inequality of the society? Does it means to what extent does it have a damaging impact on the society? How much can it actually damage the fabric of the society? That's what the learner. Hope I'm clear. Hello.
ମୁଁ ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ଲେଖୁଛି, ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ରାଇଟିଂ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ଏ ପିସ୍ ଇନ୍ ବିଟୱିନ୍ ଆଇ ଗଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ଟୁ ଦିସ୍ ହୋଲ୍ ଲେକ୍ଚର୍ You know, we have a different understanding about news. But let me give you a brief idea. This actually started with 18th and 19th century. When we were talking about the whole genesis of news in England, it started in England. Then we thought about news as a, what you call, it's actually the news is actually, what is it called? People, those who are in the high echelons in society, or those who are considered as men of letters, right? I mean, कुछ लोग जो मने कि men of letters or fourth estate, से जो होले जो ideas वड़ा देखे हमें सब उड़े news रो उड़े existence को create करा गला. Subsequently, जो 19th century आसिला market context है, से मने देखे ले जी कि news को हमें sell करी पारीवा नहीं market है. Jodi, ame we do not add certain associated terms, so that comes as objectivity, neutrality, then credibility. All these terms we packaged and we tried to push it in the market, and that's what we say, that that idea of 19th century is still colonizing in different parts of the world for centuries. In fact, ajikali ଆମେରିକାରେ ସ୍କଲର୍ସ ଲେଖୁଛନ୍ତି ଦ ଜର୍ଣ୍ଣାଲିଜମ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଥିଙ୍ଗ ବଟ୍ ଏନଦର ଫର୍ମ ଅଫ୍ ଇଜମ୍ ବୁଝିଲେ ଜର୍ଣ୍ଣାଲ ଇଜମ୍ ଆପଣ ଇଜମ୍କୁ ବ୍ରାକେଟ୍ କରିଦିଅନ୍ତୁ ଜର୍ଣ୍ଣାଲିଜମ୍ରେ ଲାଇକ୍ ସୋସିଆଲିଜମ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଜମ୍ କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲିଜମ୍ ଜର୍ଣ୍ଣାଲିଜମ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅନଦର ଫର୍ମ ଅଫ୍ ଇଜମ୍ ଜର୍ଣ୍ଣାଲିଜମ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅନଦର ଫର୍ମ ଅଫ୍ ଇଜମ୍ ହ୍ୱିଚ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନାଓ ଏକ୍ସପୋର୍ଟେଡ୍ ଟୁ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ପାର୍ଟ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ୱାର୍ଲ୍ଡ ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ପିପୁଲ୍ ଫଲୋ ଆଣ୍ଡ କଲୋନାଇଜ୍ that pattern of journalism. So it's basically about market, it's about neutrality, objectivity, credibility. All these terms, associated terms, actually came in 19th century, and we are still colonized. Kind of journalism, unfortunately, nobody, it's actually about when we try to understand, is journalism a profession? Is journalism a profession? No. It could never be established as a profession because there are two kind of a dogma. A, nobody wanted to make it a profession because the labor which is engaged in the journalism sector has no voice at all. It is actually, it is actually the market. Which actually derives, it is the ownership of the news organization, which is actually speaking on behalf of the journalist. So the labor, the journalistic labor, or the journalist has no voice at all in making a change in the system itself. So journalism as a profession, in that sense, does not exist as a vocation. But however, if you want to sell the commodities of journalism, people will not accept it like any other commodity. Hence, we need to follow that we make it accountable. We need to see that it should be credible. We need to see, in fact, you read so many now American scholars, those who are sort of trying to write, because there is a crisis today in journalism. And today, in that sense, that what you see when you talk about journalism, it's no more the same what you are talking about probably. I think the past 30, 40 years has literally brought journalism to the brink where we do not see anymore the charm of journalism anymore. It's a time that we need to redraft and also rethink creatively our understanding about journalism. That is most important. And the second one now, I forgot, what was it? Something on the marginalization. I forgot.
The damage it can cause to the society in the long run. If marginal voices are not represented properly, the damage that it can actually cause to the society in the long run. That's what the learner wanted to ask. The damage.
You see, one of my teacher used to be there. So he used to tell me that how during communalism or during communal class, communal tension, the role of media, the role of media. He wrote during that time. So he used to say, the role of media is nothing but a fire brigade approach. The role of media is nothing but a fire brigade approach. When there is a communal tension, you find that media literally initially would negate, then finally I would say that now the situation is under control. If you categorically remember this term, it says that now the situation is under control. I mean, is it possible that a communal tension or misunderstanding in society can be brought under control and situation? I think this is how our media function. This is how our media function. I think our media is never proactive. Our media is not sensitive at all to the causes in the society, the causes, the cause for which it has to function. Our media is somehow delinked. Media is not meant for the community and society at a whole, at large. I think somewhere our understanding about what we write about media, it just confines to particular sections in society, and also within that sections to certain individuals in societies and some people, rather than thinking about in a holistic way what we talk about media. I think that is what we need to critically engage rather than ask questions. And we critically engage and see that does media actually reflect, does media represent the totality or a particular sections in society? So that normative understanding of media does not hold anymore. Thank you. So obviously now when...
So there is a question from... Yes, sir. There is a question from Ridhi Kakkar, who is a learner of ours. She wants to know, she's basically introduced by the idea of social justice. Sir, keeping in mind that these are budding journalists, can you provide them some tips as to how to ensure that social justice is maintained when they go out and practice journalism, despite all the pessimism that exists? Can you give them some practical tips what they should do when they go out and work as journalists to ensure that social justice is...
You see, there are a couple of issues. Now, conventional notion of media was media houses, right? Conventional notion of media was media houses. And as a result, when you are saying budding journalists, you see, conventional notion of journalism was confined to media houses. Even they're trying to reconfigure themselves. In fact, media houses do not require any more journalists. There is a delink between journalism and the press. Journalism and the press. So now gradually you find that you should not be so aspiring for a career in all these so-called media houses. Now the avenues and opportunities are much more outside. The avenues and opportunities are much more outside. In fact, you find social media is an interesting space for that matter, where what you want to do, in fact, you can do more justice. But conventional media in that sense has gone up completely because unless we strengthen a kind of a public service broadcasting, it would be extremely difficult even to talk about justice, because justice is completely missing. I will talk about the best example probably I would like to suggest, since it is a discussion about justice. Think about Nirbhaya case. Think about Nirbhaya case. Now, if you follow the journalistic writings in the newspaper, if you see over a period of time, and if you make a solid content analysis of the newspaper, and you will find that there is an idea of justice which is missing in our journalism altogether. It's a completely missing in the, or the strand. When you say media justice, you are actually talking about how the strands in journalism also has to change and evolve over a period of time. Now, we had a time of sensation. We had a time of advocacy. Now it's a time for justice, media justice we are talking about. Media justice does not mean media trial. Let's not confuse with that. That's a mockery, what you see, the media trial. I'm talking about in your language, you emphasize about the justice which is important for a particular cause. The Nirbhaya case is probably a kind of par excellence. The way continuously there was an advocacy in the newspaper, the way, and if you see, read, I think Nirbhaya case failed miserably, that our journalists are not geared towards understanding about justice. They only follow the logical pattern of keeping the story lively, keeping the story in the limelight. Besides that, they have never done any justice in terms of bringing the story to the higher accolades, at least to be to survive in the media itself. I think gradually that went to oblivion. So I think this is a lack of our journalistic understanding about justice. They do not know how to treat the story, how to give a finality to story, except that if you read one story and the next story, you find that it's just a repetition with the past events. So this is where we miss the bus. We have a long, detailed report, which my colleagues in Canada, in York University, they did. And that whole report is there. I will send you, Asis, the report so that you can circulate. This is actually the Nirbhaya case, and my colleagues in Canada, they did. We were doing together about the Nirbhaya case. And it just so happened, before the Nirbhaya case came, we were doing on how the sex gender is being reported in a newspaper, and suddenly this incident happened. Then we had interest in seeing how the journalistic reporting on Nirbhaya Kand. And then we realized that the element of justice is missing in our journalism. And that is where we talk about media justice. I think that's enough for Riddhi. She can ask me later if she has any clarifications.
We will take just one last question, and it's our eager technical expert for the day, Devidatta Behera.
Yeah, yeah.
He wants to know if social media tomorrow can overtake the traditional newspapers and television channels, because in the process, in the process of reporting the truth, it can actually earn the credibility of the people to an extent that people start moving towards social media and they forego television and newspapers. I think that is what he wanted to ask.
You see, it's not a question of one replacing the other. It's not a question of replacing the other. We live in a society, we have not replaced anything. Orality, we can't. Literacy, we can't. Television, we can't. And today we are into social media. So it is not an exclusion of one at the cost of the other. Rather, you find that there is an overlapping of all these. So I would not say being a technocrat, probably you would like to say that, look, social media has come up in a big way. It will also be there. Still a large section of people, they would like to see much more in terms of what you see mass media. So the question is, because we are celebrating too much about youth in our society, and we say that India is a youth society, primarily it's a youth. So once you say youth, obviously they have all access to mobile. So once they have an access to mobile, samaste mobile to the kuchandi. The question arises, do the youth at all watch news in mobile, if at all? They don't watch news. I don't think they should waste time in watching news in the mobile. They have better things to do. They are creating voluntary labor, as I said. They are voluntarily contributing to labor, and that particular labor is being profiled so that they are again sent back. All their messages in the social media. But what is happening is a good thing. Because of their access to the mobile, they are also having access to informations as well as what is happening on the site, they can take the picture and they can shoot and they can send it. So in that sense, the whole idea of journalism as a scholarship has to be enriched and also has to be seen in a larger context, the how it contributes. So in that sense, I will not say a demise. Rather, I'll see that there is a possibility of a futuristic growth, as well as I find that there will be a tremendous expansion and conventional lot of meanings have to be, rethink about the way we understand the whole journalism. Probably, aaji jo kahuchanti jo journalism or a crisis, probably journalism will reinvent itself after some time, along with this new media, social media, and it will give a different meaning to journalism as a discipline. And not again, only watching and looking at the technology, our issue questions are missing, because our students today, those who are doing journalism, they're not much exposed to the issues, like jemti apana marginals visare tanku apana paduchanti, which is very rare. I'm so glad that I find a media school where they are teaching margins. You know, it's a very important issue. But you go to most of the conventional mass media courses, they are all applications. It's like hands-on training. It's a hands-on training. So that doesn't make them a good journalist at all. The best journalists were there who never had a so-called journalism training. So you should remember this. So the question is, if you have ideas, you can articulate that in any medium per se. You don't need to be trained. Aji ethe fragmentation nahi chi. Jiye jodi kahuchi je mu television sikhli, I don't know how to write. If a person who talks about writing, he doesn't know what about television. So it's much more fragmentations within the discipline. So because we are using different technologies, so we are saying that, look, I'm not skilled enough in social media. I'm skilled enough in print. So that will be over. That will be over. These are momentary attractions and tensions. I think once we have all these different medium we are trying to engage, I'm sure that we will have a renewed thinking about the discipline itself of journalism and also the issues which are most important. I think that's all.
I think that satisfies Mr. Devidatta Behera. So thank you very much. And my special thanks to Professor Das. We will surely be taking the inputs from him, written inputs, papers and other things that you'd like to share with us. I'd personally request him so that we can distribute them among our learners.
Yeah.
Learners, again, just to inform you that we have our concluding lecture on media and margins tomorrow. That is from 3:30 p.m. to 5. And that is when we discuss marginal voices and media. That is the last block of this paper on media and margins. So I thank you all and hope this was a very enlightening session and hope the experience is much different from the experiences that you had learning from your counselors, because the reason is very simple. You are listening to media and margins from the very developer of the course. So thank you all. Thank you all. Thank you very much. And we meet again tomorrow for the concluding lecture. Thank you all. Thank you, sir.